joined by Sri N.K. Premchandran ji. He is the chief guest for the policymaker and the chief guest for today's event. I'm sorry to butt in. Let Prime Point Srinivasan sir to give a small introduction about our MP, and then we will get going with this thing. Over to you, Srinivasan sir.
Sir, good evening, sir. Mr. Premchandran, in spite of, I know that you are busy with so many things, and even your family members are not feeling well, you are in the hospital. Still, in spite of that, on our request, you are able to join us, sir. In fact, we are very happy that you have joined, and we wish your family members get a speedy recovery. And in the meanwhile, I would like to introduce Mr. N.K. Premchandran. He is a fourth time MP and one of the outstanding parliamentarians, and he is a Sansad Ratna awardee, and he is presently is one of the jury committee members of Sansad Ratna Awards. And formerly, he was a irrigation minister at Kerala government. When he was the Kerala government minister, he has received the award also for his best minister award. Wherever he goes, he shows his excellence. Wherever, whichever job that he takes up, whether as a MLA or a minister or a MP, or whichever job that he undertakes, he always shows his excellence. Sir, welcome you, sir. We are greatly honored to have you here with us. This Digital Journalists Association of India was started 5 years back in 2016 by a group of journalists, and as a founder and chairman, I welcome you, because the concept is that we wanted to bring an awareness about the digital laws, digital regulation, digital ethics amongst the people. Where for the past 2 days, we are running a national conclave, and we have international speakers also we had joined. And today you have joined us in the concluding day. And over to Mr. Premchandran. We would like to hear from you, sir, and your views on it. Thank you very much, sir. Welcome, Mr. Premchandran. Over to Premchandran.
Thank you very much, Sri Srinivasan, and other distinguished guests, and also the office bearers of Digital Journalists Association of India, and my dear friends who have joined in this conclave. First of all, I take this opportunity to congratulate Prime Point Foundation for having such an association, Digital Journalists Association of India, one of the five initiatives of Prime Point Foundation. And also I have learned that you have already formed another association by name Digital Security Association of India is also. So when the digital world, or when the world is moving in the digital direction, the day-to-day life and everything is being digitalized, definitely this matter has to be well brought into the public domain, and to have and to create an awareness about it, and the way by which it is being used, the misuse of the media, and the best way by which it can be used for the public at large, and what are the means and ways by which this can be controlled to an extent. All these things will come in the digital media conclave, I think. See, second point of my congratulation is for holding such a digital media conclave for 2 days, and in which participating active involvement of the policymakers, media owners and media professionals, and other people who are interested in this area are being included in this conclave, and the different or the divergent views of the different personalities have been brought into the common platform by which we can create an awareness, not only creating an awareness, to find out or trace out some solutions which are being faced by the digital media at this juncture. So once again, I take this opportunity to congratulate Mr. Srinivasan. I know the Prime Point Foundation, which has constituted the Sansad Ratna Award for having better performance in Parliament, and is having an evaluation of the parliamentary work which is being going on in our country. And also in the digital media also, now we, for last 5 years, we are working in the digital media in the name of Digital Journalists Association of India. And on the auspices of Digital Journalists Association of...
I think there was a problem with the audio. I think we are back on track.
I'm in Delhi. You know the poor connectivity in India. The poorest connectivity in India is in Delhi, especially regarding MTNL and BSNL. That is the problem which we are facing. Anyway, I think now it's clear.
Yes, sir. We are able to hear you, Lawrence. Sir. Thank you, sir.
So I have gone through the agendas of 2 days conclave, and these very pertinent subjects and very significant issues which we have discussed. That is the impact of media, its credibility, and the rules and regulations for digital media, and digital media's the use, and how it could be the freedom of speech and expression. Almost all the issues you have covered. So it is an undisputed fact, or it is an accepted fact. Democracy, media is the fourth pillar of our democracy. And the traditional media, which we have been followed for since long, now this, even the traditional media is being replaced by this digital media. Because digital media connects people in ways which never before possible. We have never even thought of such a situation by which we can have this connectivity with the people, wherever he may be. Whether the time is not a problem and the distance is not a problem. So we have never imagined of such a situation of connectivity through the digital media. To build a friendship across time and distance, socially isolated people can also come into the mainstream. And in short, we can very well say that this digital media makes feel more connected and more informed. Digital media gives people a voice, increase civic participation, and facilitate the creation of communities. Traditional media on several occasions nowadays, it is being replaced in several areas. So digital media amplify the response to the humanitarian issues and support to these issues. If you examine during the last decade, if you verify, we can very well see that so many pertinent issues, humanitarian issues, have brought into the limelight only because of the digital media intervention. During the Arab Spring of 2011, there is a digital media served as a vehicle to mobilize the resources for the Arab Spring. So the second point which I would like to make is the information sharing. See, the information sharing is a greater access to the facts, figures, and statistics. Everything is very simple and it has become very easy. So to build up communities, organize action. Multitude of issues. All these things goes to show that the significance of digital media in the public life has become inevitable. And in India, if you examine the history of digital media in India, it has started, I think, in the year 1995 during the Independence Day, August 15, by the Videsh Sanchar Nikam Limited, VSNL. And subsequently, a revolution has took place in India regarding the digital revolution or the digital media involvement. See, first point I would like to touch upon is regarding the value of digital media in the market. It is being estimated, so many series of studies were conducted, and it is being estimated that 2020, the value of digital media in India is 235 billion Indian rupees. By 2023, it is estimated, the projected estimate is 424 billion Indian rupees. That is the participation or the value of the digital media in the market. That is, digital media is industry's growth in India is surprising. It has never even thought of. Such a growth is there. So the digital media industry's growth in India is unimaginable growth is being taken place. That is why it is being projected as 424 billion Indian rupees. That is the market share by 2023 means that we can very well see or imagine the exponential growth of digital media in our country. And that has been enhanced after COVID-19 or during the time of COVID-19 also. The studies would go to show that after the effect of this COVID-19 pandemic, global pandemic, media and entertainment industry has suffered a lot. But at the same time, the digital media, it is being marked as a big growth in digital media, especially in TV, gaming, digital and OTT platforms are seeing big growth is being recorded. So definitely at this juncture, regulation of digital media is the need of the hour. Because such a big market and such a big exponential growth of the digital media in the country, even the traditional media is being replaced by this digital media. In such a situation, definitely it is affecting even the day-to-day life, information sharing, and bringing out so many causes, and even organizing communities in almost all aspects of life. Digital media is playing a vital role in the digital media. In such a situation, definitely regulation of the digital media is also required as per the system to run. Regulation under the Information Technology Act. See, there is a code of ethics is incorporated in the Information Technology Act. The code of ethics is in conformity with the restrictions on freedom of speech and expression under Article 19(1)(a) of the Constitution. See, we all know that 19(1)(a) of the Constitution is giving the fundamental right to the freedom of speech and expression. Freedom of the press, though it is not specifically mentioned in Article 19(1)(a) of the Constitution, it is implied within the freedom of speech and expression. That is, freedom of media is also embodied in Article 19(1)(a) of the Constitution. So reasonable restrictions can be imposed on the freedom of speech and expression in protecting the sovereignty and integrity of our country, and to counter the terrorism and so many, and to avoid or restrict the anti-national activities, and so many grounds have already been stated in 19(1). So reasonable restrictions can be imposed on the freedom of speech and expression. So now we have to look into the restrictions or the regulations of digital media and its practical difficulties. See, on August 14, the Bombay High Court stayed some provisions of the Information Technology Rules 2021, which regulate intermediaries, that is the social media, communication platforms, search engines, telecom or network service providers. So the Bombay High Court has stayed some rules in restricting the rights or the freedom of these intermediaries. And the Code of Ethics, at the same time, the Code of Ethics prescribed under these IT rules appears to be unconstitutional, to restrict the freedom of right of speech and expression. This is the observation of the Bombay High Court. So the code, what the court says, the Code of Ethics incorporated in the Act says that, just like that of the Press Council of India, so many media persons are also participating in the debate. I think that they can authentically put all these issues, because there is Press Council of India under the Press Council of India Act of 1978 is there. So the digital media has to strictly comply with the provisions of Press Council of India Act of 1978, or they have to comply with the directions and guidelines enunciated by the Press Council of India. That is the first one. And the second one is, as far as the programs are concerned, as far as the program code is concerned, it is being prescribed that they should comply, the digital media should comply, the Cable TV Network Regulation Act of 1995. So the Press Council Act of 1978 and the Cable TV Network Regulation of 1995, all the provisions in these two acts have to be strictly complied in respect of the news, in respect of the information, or in respect of the programs. These two enactments are alien to the Information Technology Act 2000. By imposing these obligations and a mandatory code of ethics, finally, the observation is that will result in the a freedom of flow of information in the internet. That will be the resulting effect of it, because this is an internet media. Free flow of information, free flow of internet service is required so as to have the flooding of this news and information and the programs. I can very well cite an example. The publishers of digital media are required to exercise due caution and discretion before transmitting any content which may be deemed as anti-national or inciting disorder in the society. So this is a Press Council of India Act observation. Sorry, Press Council of India Act provision is there. Cable TV Network Act also such a provision is there. That is, you have to have the due caution and discretion before transmitting any content which may be deemed as anti-national or inciting disorder in the society. So regulatory censorship, this is the regulatory censorship of online media. This is always a debate, and now also it's a debate, and so many attempts are being coming from the government of India, and the data protection bill is being agitated, well agitated in parliament. Now, Sri Data Protection Bill, it has gone to the Standing Committee, and the Standing Committee has submitted the report day before yesterday. The Parliament is also going to discuss on the Data Protection Bill, which is also part and parcel of restricting the right and freedom of the digital media. So definitely what my point is, yes, the freedom of speech and expression is there. So you cannot restrict the freedom of the internet media or the digital media. Why? Because the spontaneous flow of information and news is the unique character of digital media or digital programs. Otherwise, nothing is there. So whether they will get a chance to scrutinize, especially the intermediaries, whether the service providers will be able to check all the contents of these things and see whether it is anti-national or it is creating any disorder in the public society, then only the contents of that media, so contents of that subject will be transmitted, means it is practically not possible. This is a practical difficulty which we are facing. So in such a situation, definitely absolute freedom without having any restrictions will never hold any good. That is our world experience. If you examine wherever it may be, absolute freedom in the sense there is no restrictions, there is no guidelines, there is no directions, nothing is there, then it will be of no good. That is our experience, even our own experience in India. So I feel that reasonable restrictions may be imposed in order to regulate the digital media. That is need of the hour. Otherwise, we all know that it is creating, when we talk about the digital media marketing, their contribution, everything, when we appreciate at the same time, the disastrous things which are being done using the digital media also has to be taken into account. When we compare these two things, the disastrous things which the digital media is doing in one side and very positive good sense of so many things which I have already made, that the creation of the communities, building up a friendship and fraternity among the people throughout the globe and so on, and sharing of information. When all these positive aspects are there, the negative aspects of the digital media has also to be taken into account. How to control it, how to regulate it. My only point is we should have a check and balance. That never means restricting the freedom of the media, internet media, but should have some control, should have some regulations, not like that of the Press Council of India and the Cable TV Network Act. But other than that, in spite of that, some regulatory mechanism has to be there so as to check whether the contents or whether the things are being published with a malafide intention to destabilize the unity and integrity of our country and to create disorder in the society or to harass anybody or with a malafide intention. That has to be checked. Yes, I do accept that cyber crimes are there, offenses are there, and courts are there, IPC provisions are there, but at the same time, a separate enactment for which is highly essential, that shall not be for restricting the freedom, but to regulate the freedom. Regulating the freedom of the digital media is highly essential, highly required. I think that most of the eminent personalities in the panelists may have their own independent opinion in this issue. I am, as a common man, especially a people's representative representing the common mass of our country, I am making my personal observation not on the basis of any authenticated study on this issue. These are my observations which I would like to make at the concluding session of this two-day conclave of the social, sorry, on this digital media organized by the Digital Journalists Association of India, which comes under the umbrella organization of Tripoint Foundation of India. With these words, I conclude. Once again, I wish this thing, conclave, digital media conclave, all the best, and let your earnest efforts to intervene in the public issues. Especially, this is one of the very serious, significant issue to be discussed at this juncture. Some legislation is required. Stringent legislation means stringent legislation to regulate, not to restrict. Once again, I repeat, not to restrict the freedom of speech and expression, not to restrict the flow of information, not to restrict any of the fundamental rights of the citizens of our country, but regulation is required. With these words, once again, I express my sincere thanks to the organizers, and also I extend my congratulations to all who are behind this digital media conclave. With these words, I conclude and express my sincere thanks for affording me this opportunity to just express my view as a policy maker, lawmaker in the country. Thank you very much.
What an excellent oration, sir, like your speech in Parliament. This is a sample, probably everybody, recently we also published his parliamentary speeches in the ebook format. Every speech of his will be like this in the Parliament, with the data and with analysis. What a wonderful speech, sir. It is an eye-opener. In fact, after you were hearing your speech, we will also ask our Delhi people, like Vinod, Priya and all, to meet you and discuss with you some of the core issues that are that the common man is facing it, so that you can, as a policy maker, you can also take up the matters with the Parliament. So thank you very much, sir. I know that with a difficult time, and you are able to spare a lot of your time with us. And thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Welcome. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you.